This is the bag that has become the subject of controversy. On one side, the logo of the Saint Lucia Tourist Board, and on the other, the logo of the ruling party. Critics say it shows that the government will stop at nothing in attempts to get re-elected.
Those bags clearly display the Saint Lucia Tourist Board logo. It cannot be right that the promotion of Saint Lucia, what is being used to promote Saint Lucia outside to bring in tourists, is now being used for naked partisan activity by Minister Chastanet.
But Mr. Chastanet, who is the tourism minister and the UWP candidate for Soufriere, says the Saint Lucia Tourist Board and the government had nothing to do with the items. Speaking via telephone from Soufriere, Mr. Chastanet noted that when St. Lucia's new branding position was developed, it was a country and not a tourism brand.
The logo itself, which is actually the colors of the flag in the shape of the pitons, is a country branding position. And we've been encouraging everyone to use it as a form of patriotism. So, for instance, NDC's investment is using it, and Pinnacle is using it, and we're trying to encourage as many people. I see no difference in terms of using that brand position than me standing behind a St. Lucia flag. The United Workers Party puts country ahead of politics.
According to Mr. Chastanet, the United Workers Party is very proud of St. Lucia and demonstrates it by using the country's brand. But aside from the controversial bag, Mr. Chastanet is also being criticized over news reports that he suggested to a benefactor to place hurricane relief funds with the Soufriere Development Foundation, although the money was being negotiated for by the Soufriere Town Council.
Minister Chastanet is not the Minister for Local Government. He's not the district representative. What is his legal authority to have caused the benefactor to have placed that money not with the Soufriere Town Council, which negotiated it, but it's the Soufriere Foundation, which has nothing to do with it.
Mr. Francis says this represents naked politicizing of state resources and state symbols, as in the case of the bag with the tourist board and the UWP logo. But Mr. Allen Chastanet has defended his position.
Instead of monies coming to me directly, I've encouraged monies to go into the Soufriere Foundation or the Soufriere Town Council. Depending what the money was going to be used for, is which one we would select. So, for instance, when we got money from the Taiwanese to do the lights in the playing field and to fix up the playing fields, we put that money into the Soufriere Town Council because they're the ones responsible for the maintenance of those facilities. When it came to the Hummingbird Beach project, because there would be vendors and all kinds of economic activity on that beach, we felt that the Soufriere Foundation would be the best person best placed for that.
According to Mr. Chastanet, after Hurricane Tomas, there were two emergency funds set up in the town council and the Soufriere Foundation. He says there was about $300,000 available in the town council, but he caused the remaining funds to go to the foundation since it was impossible for the town council to execute the works involved. For the DBS News World, Alex Buske reporting.